Alright, so we've got some activity going on today where we're going to be looking at just your simple analysis of variance. And recall when we did t-tests, we were comparing means of two groups. The difference between analysis of variance and t-test is that we compare the variance in analysis of variance, not the means. So what we have here is three different groups of outcome, a rating score depending on hours of practice one is doing. So, and we want to see if these different groups are different. And through the magic of having a remote desktop connection, I'll show you how to do it on PCs, Macs using StatPlus, and then I'll show you how to do it in R. So, okay, Data Analysis Tool Pack has several functions for ANOVA. There's a single factor with replication and a two-factor without replication. So what they mean by factor is there's one thing that we're testing, and so what we're the factor we're testing here is hours of practice and its effect on these outcome scores. So two factors would be hours of practice and, say, gender or race, or hours of practice and something else. So with replication is going to be when you have some sort of a paired test. So you've got two factors, and then you've got pretest, post-test. So we'll get into that in the next chapter. So let's stick to chapter 13. So it's just the single factor analysis of variance. You click OK, and you notice that Excel just gives you one box. So just grab all the data that you want to put into your analysis of variance. It will be smart enough to know that those are blanks there and won't replace them with zeros, I hope. It's theoretically it's supposed to be smart enough to do that. We've got labels in the first row, and it knows to ignore those boxes as empty, those cells as empty, because we did our grouping in columns. So it says, okay, I'm comparing this column, and we'll put this over in something called ANOVA, and click OK, and we get our answer back lickety-split almost quicker than we can count. So let me go ahead and make my output a little bit bigger, a little bit easier to read here on the World Wide Web. Okay, so we get some output. Let's clean it up. That's always a good idea. Let's make these values a little bit more sane. Down to point, two decimal points is much more readable for me. Now, we don't need these mean of squares that much in our analysis, or the sum of squares, but we'll just, for consistency's sake, go ahead and make them like the rest of them. So, okay, we have some output. How are we going to analyze this? So, going back to our now famous eight-stage process in Salkind, we set our null hypothesis. Our famous eight-stage process starts with, of course, our null hypothesis, that there's no difference between the mean of our sample and the population means. And our alternative is alternative hypothesis is that there is a difference between our three samples, that one is not equal to two, which is not equal to three. So, and then we select our appropriate test statistic, which in this case is the analysis of variance. Let's go down. We complete this test statistic, compute the between groups and the within groups and the total sum of squares, or we could let the analysis toolpack do it for us. Determine the value needed for null rejection using the table, or let the analysis toolpack do it for us. And compare the obtained value with the critical value. So those plans are just like they were for t-test, just like they were for z-test, and just like they were for the other two. If the obtained value is more extreme than the critical value, the null hypothesis cannot be accepted, which would mean that it's different. Okay, so let's take a look at what we need to look at. Up here in our summary, it just gives us our means, our averages for each group, for the 15 hours, for the 15 to 25 hours, and then for the over 25. And we can see that there's not much difference in them, actually. Then we want to look down here at our ANOVA test, and our F value is going to be just simply called F. You know, it doesn't say F obtained, but Excel is nice enough to give us an F critical value, so bravo for them. And we can see that our F value does not exceed our F critical, and of course we got a really lousy probability score, 0.85 instead of 0.05. So we can accept the null hypothesis as the most attractive explanation of what's going on, and we cannot accept research hypothesis. So what we're saying is there's no difference between these groups. So pretty simple to do. Now, Stat Plus, for you Macintosh users, if you've gotten used to it yet, pretty straightforward. So here's that same data in a local locally held spreadsheet. I want to go up here to statistics, and they got a whole section of analysis of variance. Yikes. We just want to choose the simple one, the one-way ANOVA unstacked. And again, just like the other one, it gives us the option to select just a range of data. And so we have to select all three of those columns, labels in the first row. We can select our output. The nice thing about Stat Plus, we don't have to fool around with going back and reformatting. We can also set our alpha level. 5% is what we want. That's your probability alpha, probability level. And if this was paired, we might want to remove missing values, but we don't have any missing values that we need to worry about getting rid of, because these are three different groups. They're not paired groups. Then we simply click OK. Stat Plus does its ANOVA. It's a little bit slower for some reason than regular Excel. Don't know why. But let's go ahead and make this a little bit larger. If we can find my where's my zoomer? Zoomer and Mac's in a little bit different place. Okay. F critical, 3.28. F obtained, P level. So We get the same results. Of course, that's not surprising. Now, R doesn't like to have data that's laid out this way. It causes it to be confused. And then, you know, sometimes you get data that looks like this, where this is the same data is laid out like that. Let me go ahead and import both of these into R, and then we'll show you how to deal with that in kind of two different ways. Okay, so let's import our data from our Excel file. Okay, we'll call it ANOVA 1. And where did we put that? It's in my Dropbox. Dropbox can be nice to keep stuff handy. It's in... Spring of 14, week by week. And week 9. Let's go ahead, I think it's that one. And we'll start with sheet 1. View my data sheet. There it is, looking good. We'll go ahead and do the same thing to get the other sheet in there. We'll just call it ANOVA 2. Same thing. It's in the one called R import. All right. So there's two ways to deal with this sort of a situation. When we take a look at our data when it's set up, just like we had it in R, it doesn't give us the ability to do a multi-way ANOVA. So that's one of the reasons that we want to change our data around if we're working in R. So going over to this one, there I've got my one-way ANOVA. So I only have two possibilities. I have my practice hours and I have my score. So I click OK. And that gives me, again, that F value of 16.0016 and a probability of 0.85, just like we saw in Excel. We've got 2 degrees of freedom, 2 and 33 degrees of freedom, again, just like we saw in Excel. So we don't have a significant test, so we can assume that our critical value has not been exceeded. But sometimes that's not a safe assumption. So we would have to go look at the table, or if we're lazy, we can just type in QF and then our probability level, 0.95 is our probability level, and then our numerator, then our denominator as far as our degrees of freedom, and then we can click submit. And here we get our critical value, 3.2849. So let's go back over here to our Excel page and pop those findings back up. Where are you at? My stats plus results. And again, 3.28 on our critical value, 2849. So You can also do that with your t-tests as well, FYI. Just your probability value and your degrees of freedom. Type QT instead of QF, and you'll get your critical value. So that's a nice way to get your critical value. Now, if you wanted to set your test higher, say 0.99, it would give you a different critical value. Nice little tool built into R that keeps you from having to go thumb around in those tables. So that's it, I think, for today. So enjoy doing your analysis of variance.